The arrival of the first two Lockheed Martin F-35s at RAAF Williamstown on December 10th, 2018, marked the start of operations for Australia's first fifth-generation fighter and paved the way for the Air Force's transition to a fifth-generation fighting force. The F-35 is the world's most advanced multi-role stealth fighter, featuring speed, agility, stealth technology, advanced data links, mission systems, and sensor fusion capabilities. The Australian F-35 program is the largest acquisition activity in the RAAF's history. Initially with 72 aircraft and associated weapons, support equipment, and logistics systems on order. The F-35 was born out of the United States Joint Advanced Strike Technology Program. Following the cancellation of the USAF Multi-Role Fighter and US Navy Advanced Fighter Attack programs, the Joint Advanced Strike Technology Program became the Joint Strike Fighter Program in 1995, with the goal of creating a concept demonstrator aircraft. The demonstrator was to be an aircraft capable of replacing many multi-role and strike fighters in the US Navy and Marine Corps inventories with short takeoff and vertical landing capability. On November 16, 1996, Boeing, Lockheed Martin, McDonnell Douglas, and Northrop Grumman's demonstrator submissions were evaluated. Boeing and Lockheed Martin were chosen to produce prototypes and were named the X-32 and X-35. Boeing's X-32 made its first flight on September 18, 2000, followed by Lockheed Martin's X-35 on October 24th the same year. The X-35 won the competition on October 26, 2001, and Lockheed Martin was awarded a system development and demonstration contract. Over the next 5 years, modifications to the basic X-35 design resulted in the final F-35 design and three variants. The F-35A is a conventional takeoff and landing aircraft. The F-35B is designed for short takeoff and vertical landing. And the F-35C is a carrier variant of the aircraft. The F-35A made its first flight on December 15, 2006, in Fort Worth, Texas. And this was the variant that Australia decided to purchase. Prior to this decision to purchase the F-35A, Australia had participated in the system development and demonstration phase of the global F-35 program to learn about the aircraft in anticipation of replacing their aging FA-18 Classic Hornet and F-111 fleets. In 2006, Australia received approval to enter the production, sustainment, and follow-on development phase of the F-35 program, giving Australia some visibility and influence over the F-35 program without a commitment to purchase the aircraft. By November 2009, the Australian Department of Defence received their second pass approval to manage a staged acquisition of the aircraft, starting with 14 F-35As and associated training. In April 2014, the Australian government approved an additional 58 aircraft, with associated support systems and facilities to achieve initial operational capability by 2020 and final operational capability by 2023. This brought the total approval for Australian F-35A aircraft to 72. The Australian public got their first look at the acquisition when Wing Commander Andrew Jackson and Squadron Leader David Bell, the first Australian pilots to qualify for the F-35A, made their home debut at the Australian International Air Show in March 2017. The following year, in 2018, the Australian Air Force accepted the next 8 F-35s and began operations at the USAF's Luke Air Force Base, Arizona. These aircraft had Block 3F mission system software installed, providing increased warfighting capability and meeting the Australian initial operational capability. On December the 10th, 2018, the 9th and 10th aircraft to be handed over to the RAAF flew into the Williamtown base to be the first F-35A Lightning II fighters to be permanently based in Australia. It was expected that the RAAF would increase its fleet of F-35s from the approved 72. However, in April 2024, it was confirmed that these additional aircraft would not be purchased, with funds redirected to long-range missiles, maintaining the Super Hornet, and other priorities consistent with the National Defence Strategy. It is important to point out that the F-35 extends beyond the aircraft platform to its sophisticated supporting systems and infrastructure. The Australian F-35A project invests around $1 billion in essential infrastructure at the Williamtown base. Support also encompasses the developing Joint Air Battle Management System, providing command and control architecture for the Australian Defence Force's growing integrated air and missile defence capability, and the unique Offboard Information Systems Centre, handling the F-35 fleet's autonomic logistics information system for maintenance, fault diagnosis, supply support, mission planning, and training management for the F-35A weapon system. Australia has also collaborated with the UK and US to establish a laboratory for developing and testing mission data files for the F-35A to be a smart aircraft. Developing an effective reprogramming solution is crucial for achieving the aircraft's fifth generation capabilities and meeting Australia's operational needs. The RAAF have taken delivery of 63 F-35s, with the last 9 expected to start arriving by the end of 2024. These will come with a Technology Refresh 3 package, which includes additional munitions capabilities, target recognition, jamming, cybersecurity, sensor and user interface improvements, processing and data storage enhancements. These stealth multi-role fighter aircraft are currently serving in numbers 3, 77 and 75 squadrons and will remain Australia's frontline combat aircraft for many years to come.